must issue enthroned commands. Ephesians chapter 2, verses 4 through 7. But God, who is rich in mercy, because of his great love with which he loved us, even when we were dead in trespasses, made us alive together with Christ, by grace you have been saved, and raised us up together and made us sit together in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus, that in the ages to come he might show the exceeding riches of his grace and his kindness towards us in Christ Jesus. The scriptures are teaching us in this passage that you and I as believers have been made to sit together with Christ in the heavenly realms. We are seated on his throne. We are enthroned with him. Now we are exploring the implications of this. The fact that God did it on purpose. He did it with a reason. The reason he enthroned us is so that we could live out of that position in Christ. So we begin to live out of our place of us being seated with Christ. We begin to think from that perspective. We begin to live life from that perspective. And we must also learn to issue commands from that perspective. Meaning that when you speak in authority, when you speak in faith, and when you speak in the name of Jesus, it is no longer an ordinary man speaking here on earth, but it is you speaking out of your position in Christ at your Father's right hand, at the Father's right hand. These are issued decrees, or these are commands that are being issued from the very throne of God. That is the authority of speaking in faith and speaking in the name of Jesus. That you and I must understand that that's the realm from which we are coming when we speak those words. So we can just call it enthroned commands or enthroned decrees, or you know, whatever language you and I want to use to describe this. But the point is, as a believer, you can speak words that come forth directly from the throne of Almighty God, because you and I are seated there. We do it by faith, and we do it in the name of Jesus. Now, this again, I'm emphasizing, is that it's not just some nice imaginary things we're talking about, but this is what God has done for us in Christ. You see, how did Jesus exercise this? When Jesus faced the storm, he rebuked the winds and the waves. He spoke to them. Why would he speak to them? Because those words were words that exercised, that released his authority over things on the earth. And in the same way, when you and I speak, we speak words of authority. We speak words from the right hand of the Father over those things. When you speak against demonic works, when you speak against sicknesses, when you speak against diseases, you are speaking from a position that is in Christ Jesus at the Father's right hand. Where the word of a king is, there is power. Let's pray. Father, we ask that you'll help us understand, comprehend, and embrace this truth of us being enthroned with Christ. And help us to speak words of authority from the Father's right hand to see things done here in our world. Thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.